KPIs, or key performance indicators, are the critical metrics of progress that communicate pieces of information that are associated with the goals or objectives that you currently have in your business, although these can also be used in your personal life. They don't have emotions, and they provide you with the truth of where you're really at. They're the quantifiable outcome-based statements on where you're strong, where you're weak, measured against what you want to achieve, and by when. There are three types of KPIs that you need to be aware of: raw numbers, progress, and change. And in order for your KPIs to work well, you need to have these seven attributes. The name of the KPI, which is the verbal expression you are measuring, the source, where you are collecting the data from, the standard, which is the numeric value that must be hit without exceptions, the average, which is the numeric value that you typically hit, the target, which is the numeric value that you aim to achieve by a specific due date, the stretch goal, which is the numeric value that is a bit unrealistic to achieve but isn't totally impossible, and then the reporting frequency, how often you are reporting on the KPI. This right here is an example of a KPI tracking sheet that GravelCastle provides to our clients. As you can see, there are the seven attributes on here, and it is a great tool for, again, tracking those KPIs and actually putting those numbers on paper and taking initiative to make sure that you do indeed track those important metrics for your business. While there are many different KPIs that you likely want to start tracking, a couple that we definitely recommend you start tracking now are number of qualified leads that you get every single month, your sales closing ratio for sales calls, number of applications booked, the monthly profit that you bring in, monthly revenue, which is important, but again, profit's the main thing that you want to start tracking because that's what you actually want. It doesn't matter how much you make, it's how much you keep. The number of referrals that get brought into your business, the employee turnover rate, average cost per click, the return on investment for your marketing expenses, all these different things are KPIs that you can start tracking. But depending on your business, you probably have specific KPIs that you definitely want to start tracking that maybe other businesses won't want to start tracking, or at least don't need to, but you do. Either way, it's important to know the difference between leading indicators and lagging indicators. Lagging indicators are essentially the outcomes that you want to achieve, such as revenue that you bring in, or specifically the profit that you bring in, because it's not about what you make, it's about what you keep, right? But then at the same time, this can be applied to your personal life. So maybe it's the weight that you lost or weight that you gained if you wanted to gain weight. So the leading indicators are essentially the things that actually move that needle forward that bring that end result of the lagging indicators. So if your goal is, hey, I want to bring in more profit, well, what do you need to do on the front end to drive that end result? Okay, maybe you need to focus on getting more applications brought in from people wanting to work with you, or sales calls, or maybe it's increase the sales, close ratio. Whatever those specific things are that you do on the front end that bring that end result that you want, focus on those things, because you don't just focus on, oh, I want to go make more money. No, you focus on the activities of what needs to happen on the front end to drive that end result. Same with losing weight, right? Okay, if I want to have the end result of losing weight, or say it's gaining weight, maybe I need to make sure I'm going to the gym at least 5 times a week. And maybe I'm working out for at least an hour every time I work out. Not that that's specifically what you need to do, but you get the point. You can see how it's important to actually measure this, and it doesn't just apply to business. It applies to your personal life as well. So there's a link below where I'm gonna actually give you access to this KPI tracking sheet. Hey, this isn't just more information for you. Stop watching other videos on YouTube and start doing the very thing that you already know you need to do, but you haven't been doing. This KPI tracking sheet right here, use this and start tracking those numbers. Because if you're not tracking the numbers that you need to be tracking, or you already are, but you realize, you could actually be tweaking what numbers you're tracking, make this video that you're watching right now your wake-up call that switches everything and gets you to start tracking those numbers in not only your business, but also in your personal life, because that is how you drive the end result that you're looking to achieve. My name is Ken Conklin, and I hope that you got value from this video. Make sure to subscribe to GravelCastle's YouTube channel, so that way we can provide you with the frameworks, systems, and protocols for mastering the game of massive expansion in both your business and your personal life. I will see you in the next video.